She'll never notice how I feel. From out of the shadow, she walks like a dream. Make me feel crazy, make me feel so mean. Nothing gonna save you from the love that's blind. Slip to the dark side of your side.
I know most of you guys got it yesterday, but I have to wait. My post office sucks, and I have to wait a little while, so I didn't get mine till today, but oh well, I'm happy that I got it, and I've got a lot of things to do today, so this one's going to be kind of a quick one. This month's themes are It. I believe we're getting two items from It. I think Jay mentioned that on his Facebook page. Also, we're getting something from Terrorvision, which the just-turned 16-year-old is super excited about. We're also getting something from Dawn of the Dead or Day of the Dead, and what else? I know there's one other theme. What is the other theme we're doing? It, Terrorvision, Dawn of the Dead, and... Oh, Dexter, that's right, Dexter. All of these are very good ones, although I'm not going to front. It is probably one of my least favorite Stephen King books. Like, if I would have to put my least... I've been reading Stephen King since I've been 11 years old. I love the man. But I'm not a big fan of the book It, but I do love the miniseries and Tim Curry It. He totally made that role his. I loved his performance. The miniseries has a lot of other good actors in it, so I'm excited for the It ones. And also, I have never watched Dexter. I know the premise of it. I really like the actor, Michael C. Hall. I saw his work in 6 Feet Under. And I do want to eventually watch the series. It's on Netflix, and I have Netflix. The reason I haven't is because there were books by, I think the author is Jeff Lindsay. I am one of those weird people. I'm a bookworm, and I almost always have to read the book before I watch the movie or the show that it's based off of. So if any of you guys have actually read the books, please leave some comments down and let me know how much different or how faithful they were to the book, how different from the show. The only other thing I know besides the basic premise of it is that my son did watch it. And while he really enjoyed the first few seasons, he said the last couple of seasons, kind of the show was going downhill, and that the series finale was abysmal. And I've heard that from a couple other friends. It's pretty much universal. Everyone hated the way that show ended. So I don't know how it ends, but I remember everyone saying they hated that. So, but I am going to start to read that book when I get a chance. Before the end of this year, I will start that book series. So if any of you guys out there have watched it, please drop me a comment and let me know. I'd love to hear what you guys thought of the book versus the show. So enough of me rambling. Let me read the quotes that Jay always puts on there, and then we'll unbox. This month's quote we get, life isn't black and white, it's a million gray areas, and that is Ridley Scott, and that's a very great quote. And then the other one is, while an original is always hard to find, he is easy to recognize, and that's John Landis. I like both of those quotes. So without further ado, let's open the box. I need to get a knife. I need to get a cool unboxing knife. One of these months I'm going to get a cool unboxing knife. Let's see. So, sorry if I was talking a little fast, guys, but I do have a million other things to do. Oh, and I do have my unboxing bulldog, Brutus. let's see. So, here we go. Here's what... Ooh, we've got a shirt this month. I see a shirt. Woo! What is it? Oh, this is a cool one. I love it. Ah, it is It, guys, and it is an amazing shirt. I really like it. I hope you guys can see it good. oh, I like this shirt a lot. It's very foreboding. I've seen a lot of It shirts, but I like this one a lot. I might even put this one on today. I've got to run a few errands into town, so I might change my shirt later. I see we have, what is next month? And I already know next month because I stalked Jay on Facebook. And let me tell you guys, if you guys have not ordered for June's box, I strongly suggest you stop this video and go give Jay your money as soon as possible, because this box is going to sell out even faster than normal, because we have Sleepaway Camp in next month's box. We also have Dead Alive, Texas Chainsaw Massacre, and Monster Squad. This is a phenomenal box. I cannot wait for this, for June's box. So, Jay already has my money. And oh my god, I see a figure. Oh my god, I see... What? It's a Monsters George A. Romero's Day of the Dead figure, and it's Bub Deluxe Action Figure. Oh my god, that is so cool, guys. This is one of the reasons why I love Fright Crate, because I don't know of any other box in this price range that gives you figures. I know some of your really higher-end boxes do figures, but that is it. And I cannot afford those boxes, so... Oh my god, this is so cool, guys. I love it! Oh, this is so cool! Brutus loves it, too. This is so cool. Wow. This is definitely going, and I don't have very many horror figures, so this is another reason. If you're like someone like me that doesn't have very many, this is a good place to start your collection. And Jay did an interview recently on YouTube. I'll link that interview with the video, and where he said what he wants for the future of Fright Crate, and he says he'd like to put in even more figures, more autographs, so awesome. I'm very much approve of both of those ideas. So, wow, this is just, oh, I love it. So great. This is going, I have, you guys can't see it, it's off camera, but I have a bookshelf just of little, my Garbage Pail figures and a few other figures that I have, and this will make a very nice addition. And there's still more, guys. There is still more. I see. It's a balloon. How cute is that? Turn Back Now. It's from the miniseries. That miniseries was a really big deal. I remember my mom loved that miniseries when it came out on television, and I remember that scene from it. So that is so cool, guys. Turn Back Now. I'm going to do something decorative with this balloon. I don't know exactly what yet, but I'm going to do something decorative. The next item we have is a Terror Vision item. This is what the 16-year-old was super excited about. And it's a certificate of authenticity. Oh, we have an autograph! Jay, this is like the second autograph in 2 months! Awesome! Is this cool, Brutus? Oh my god! Isn't that cool? Of Diane Franklin, known for her portrayal in Susie and Terror Vision. My son also told me that she's done a lot of full moon stuff. If you're familiar with a lot of the full moon work, you see her a lot in the full moon. So very, very cool. He was very excited for the Terror Vision, and I think he was hoping it was going to be an autograph. So this just turned 16-year-old is going to be super excited for this one. Oh, and we have a pin. Oh, the Bay Harbor Butcher. Blood sometimes it sets my teeth on edge. Other times it helps me control the chaos. Wow, great pin. This is also going to go to the just turned 16-year-old. He turned 16 on May 27th. He has a horror jacket, and he will love this. He liked Dexter, except for the ending. But he enjoyed Dexter, so that'll look really cool on his horror jacket. Jay always gives the most phenomenal pins. Wow, I love all the blood in the blood soaked on the face. That is super cool, guys. The 16-year-old will be very pleased with that. And we still have more. Oh, we have a print. Oh, and I love every print that we get here. And this one is Pennywise. And again, I love this. The artist this month is Matthew Howard. I don't know him personally, or I've never heard of any of his work, but obviously he's very talented just from looking at this. This is amazing, guys. Beautiful work. This is definitely going in a frame and on my wall. I love all these art prints. Don't you want it? Pennywise print art. Awesome. I love that. He has an Instagram at Zip Tattooist and an Etsy store, Zip Prints. So go check him out. I will link him in the bottom of the description, guys. This is just, wow, I love this print. This is probably my favorite thing in the box so far. I even like it better than the figure, and I love the figure, but I love this art print. I love that Jay puts these beautiful art prints in our boxes every month. So very, very cool. I love that. Let's see. Oh, and we got another art print! Wow! This is so cute! And I'm a music junkie, so this works perfectly. It's Pennywise and a Nirvana mashup. That is so cool, guys! They float. That is so cute. That is just charming. I'll see if the 16-year-old wants this, but I kind of don't want to because this would also look cool on my wall, but one of us will really enjoy this. Since I'm getting so much of the It stuff, I might let the 16-year-old have this because he's a music junkie too, but he's not the biggest Nirvana fan. I don't know. I guess I didn't raise him right. but I am. But this is very cool, guys. I love this. This is just really cute. This is just charming. And I think that's the end of our box, guys. Let's see. The Pennywise shirt design was by Black Forest Media, and again, I will link there with that on the bottom of my description. Very, very cool, guys. And I think that's about the end of my box. So, except for the cheat sheet, what's in the box? Day of the Dead deluxe figure, Bub or Dr. Tongue. You could have gotten either one. I've gotten Bub. Exclusive Pennywise t-shirt, designed by Black Forest Media. TerraVision celebrity autograph. Cool. That is so cool. I love that you're giving all these autographs, Jay. This one will go to the 16-year-old, but still awesome, awesome. Exclusive Bay Harbor Butcher pin. Awesome. Love that. Exclusive Turn Back Now balloon. I think what I'm going to do with the balloon, I'm not going to inflate it because eventually it'll deflate. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put that in with the print or maybe the Nirvana print. I'm not sure. I'll put it in with one of the prints maybe. That way you can still see it, but it won't deflate. Exclusive They Float art print. I think that is just charming. That is so cute. And although I didn't get any extras, the extras you could have gotten was a TerraVision Kool-Aid shirt limited to 10 or an Ice Truck Killer doll also limited to 10. I did not get either one of those, but that's okay because I love everything I got this month. Amazing box as always. And like I said, guys, if you haven't subscribed to Fright Crate, go do it. Especially you want to get started. June is a great month to get started because it's going to be a phenomenal, phenomenal month. I am so excited for June, but I love everything in May. I just love Fright Crate. before I go, guys, I do want to get to know my audience better. So if you like this video, please hit that subscribe button. And I thought before I end this, I'd like to get to know, and since I mentioned books about the Dexter books earlier, I thought I'd like to know what you guys read. Do you guys just read horror? And if you do just read horror, what authors do you like? Or are you eclectic and like to read a lot of different things? Me, personally, I enjoy horror. I've been reading Stephen King since I was just a little kid, obviously. But I also like authors such as Matt Shaw, Wade Garrett. Those are some. Edward Lee is another favorite of mine. When I go into the horror, I like very extreme, dark, twisted stuff. I know there's a couple of other authors I'm forgetting, but those are some of my main ones. But I also read other stuff. Like I said, I'm very eclectic because another author I really enjoy is Philip Gregory, who writes a lot about the Tudors. My son rolls his eyes and thinks it's so sad, but I really enjoy those books. But I also like to read celebrity biographies if it's somebody that interests me, or just not even necessarily celebrities, just anybody in person. I enjoy the true crime books. I enjoy bestsellers. I even enjoy chick books. But I don't like the happy, lighthearted chick books. I'm more into the more melodrama, dark, heavy, where someone's dying or the relationship doesn't work out and they have to go their separate ways. But that's kind of, so I'm kind of all over the place when I read, but I'd love to hear what you guys read. What are some of your favorite authors? Let's get to know each other. So please hit that subscribe button and take some time and send me a comment and let me know what you guys read. And also let me know if anyone out there has read the Dexter books, because I'd really like to hear you guys' thoughts and opinions. I hope everyone has a great day. I've got a lot to do, so I'm rushing. I hope everyone has a wonderful day, and I'll talk to you later. Oh, I will probably be uploading a video tomorrow, my top 10 Tales from the Crypt episode. So check out for that. Hope everyone has a wonderful day, and bye!